Okay.
Everything's good. Let's go back to ZBrush. So in our last live stream session, we finished the sculpting, and today we are going to use decimation master to turn down the polygon count in this pulley model. So to use that, what you have to do is you have to go to Z plugin, and here you see this decimation master. And before we decrease the polygon count, we have to pre-process this mesh. So I'm going to click this pre-process current because we only have one subtool. I merged everything together by using this merge option. So I'll go to Z plugin and click on this pre-process, and it will take few seconds or minutes depending on your system. So our process is done, and I'm going to turn on this polyframe so you can see the difference. And again, we have to go to Z plugin, and first we're going to use the default value and see how it works out. And we have to click on this decimate current, and again it will take a few seconds to work on this. And from 7 million polygons to we are 1.4 million, we still need to turn it down a little bit more. So I'm going to go back to Z plugin, and I'm going to change the percentage of decimation, and let's set to 10, and again decimate current, and we are now on to 700 polygons. And as you can see that all our high poly detail are intact. And we can also turn it down a little bit further. So let's go back, and this time I'll change it to something like 7, and click on decimate current. So now we are down to 500,000 polygons, which is still high for something like this. You can also turn it down, but for now I'll just work with this. So I'm going to save my file first. And we're going to export this as OBJ. So we have exported this, and now we are going to go to Maya. It stopped. No, it's not stopped. I'm just waiting for my Maya to open. Alright, so I'm in, and let's import our mesh. So I'll just go to file and import. And again, this might take few minutes depending on your system. Alright, so we have this high poly mesh here. Now we didn't duplicate this side in ZBrush. We can do that in Maya. So first I'm gonna retopologize this part, and then we can duplicate the high and low poly together. So first you have to go to mesh and separate this. And I'm going to place this on the grid. Like this. So first we are going to retopologize this handle. So we'll start one by one. So I'm going to start with this. I'm going to isolate it. And for the topology to work, you need to make your surface live. So you can do that by going here and dragging and dropping this in this live surface. And if it doesn't work, what you can do is you can select this and click on this icon, and this will do the same thing. So either we can use Quadro tool for this. So we can take Quadro tool and make some points like this, and then expand. Or what you can do is you can take a cylinder, and we can use that by using conform. We can wrap that cylinder around this part. So I'm going to take a cylinder, increase the radius. And turn off the caps, go to front view, maybe add one or two subdivision for the caps as well. Yes, I'm going to tell you that in just a minute. So for now I'm going to turn off this live surface and extend these vertices like this, and also increase the subdivision in height. And if it deforms your shape, then you can use connect tool. Like this. So again, select this, make it a live surface, select your cylinder, go to mesh display and use conform. And if it doesn't work again, then let's remove the faces and try again. Mesh display and conform. So it's not working. Alright, so we need to do this old-fashioned way. So I'm going to take Codro tool, and you can use left mouse click to create the points like this, and then press shift and create a polygon out of it. And again, you can click and press shift, and you can also move and position your vertices, and also press shift to relax. So keep adding more points like this, and press shift to create a polygon. You can also extrude this. So if you press tab and with your left mouse button, you can extrude it like this. You don't have to create points for a familiar position like this. So if you want to snap this vertex to here, so you can just use your left mouse button and just snap like this. It will attach to the nearest vertex itself. So if you press W or take any other tool, and if you want to continue from that position, so if you just take Codro tool again, then you'll start from the same position, so you don't have to create a new shape every time. So if you want to extrude this whole edge loop here, you have to press tab, and with your middle mouse button, you can extrude like this. And then maybe like this, or with your left mouse button, you can place these vertices here. Just taking a cylinder and then merging it with all these vertices would be much better. Right, so if you want to add an edge loop here, you can press Control, and with your left mouse button, you can add a loop like this, and it will adjust the shape automatically. And you can repeat the same process down here. So let's do that. I'm going to press tab, and with my middle mouse button, extrude this part, and then this part like this, and with my left mouse button, I'm going to place these vertices here around this shape. And if you see something like this, you can press shift and just smooth your vertices and relax like this.
You should use the top one for this, it's very fast.
Yes, agreed. Now remember, we could easily make a low poly version of it in ZBrush itself. So you can just remesh it and create low poly in ZBrush also. So if you face some problems like this, just go back. And create points and manually create a shape. So again, shift and left click is to create the polygon out of these points. And crude for you have to manually do it here again. And we can now just manually extrude all this shape. Like this, and we can repeat the same thing here. So this is the low poly version of the handle of the pulley. We can also tweak this a little bit and remove some of these edges if you want it extremely low poly. And we also have to make it completely quad, so we have to remove this triangle. And you can either just select all the alternate edges or maybe I'm missing something. Right. So I'm going to select all these and just delete and take my multicut tool. But before that, we have to select our high poly and disable the live. Take multicut tool and let's combining these vertices. So we have one extra edge here. I'm going to select this and maybe delete it and see if we can just tweak this a little bit and if it works. So I'm going to select these two and pull these to left a little bit like this, and I think this can work. I'll just pull these up. So one more thing we have to do, if you have these hard edges in your low poly mesh, you have to go to mesh display and set them to soften edge. This will help you in the baking process. And we have to repeat the same thing here. So I'm going to select all these and delete, take my multicut and make these quad. I'm going to rename it as handle low poly. Go to display, show and all to bring back rest of your model. And let's move on to this part. Again, isolate it and make it live and take your photo tool again and start creating these points and a polygon out of it. So we can add some loops after we're finished with the basic shape. And I'm going to delete this face, go to vertex mode, select all these vertices, and then scale them like this. Pull them back. And let's create a duplicate. And rotate. And see if it works. Select these two. First, we have to combine border tool and then merge these points down. And I'm going to extrude this. And the normals are reversed. I'm going to go back to mesh display and again reverse these normals. And to select these and bevel. And move this to left a little bit. And let's select these two and bevel. I'm going to select all these vertices and move this a little bit to this side. Go to mesh display and soften edges. Rename it as handle part. Low poly. So these two parts are done. Let's move on to the big part. And again, select this isolated make live surface. And for this, again, use quadro tool.
Is there anything wrong with your model? Why is it black from bottom?
Sorry?
Is there anything wrong with the model?
Are you talking about this part here?
Yeah.
I think this is just some...
Then decimation master.
Yeah, this goes by decimation master. I think this is because of some the back facing issue.
Let's see wireframe.
Yeah, but I think this should be a problem in baking. If it does, then it will manually paint out this in emit inclusion map. We'll deal with it as we go further in this series.
You're missing the edges.
Sorry?
You're missing the edges. This yeah. is not how you start it.
No, I'm going to add a loop here.
These polygons are so big.
Talking about this?
The polygon are so big from previous.
Oh yeah. Okay, so these three parts are done, and I'll finish these two off stream, and I'm going to finish and wrap up this stream here. So you get the idea how the topology is done in Maya. The next one, we probably unwrap this and then move to Substance Painter for texturing. So if anyone have any question, you can ask now. Alright, so I'm going to finish the recording here and I'll post this on the channel tomorrow. Thanks for joining in.